Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
From a new species of ancient humans to a mystery illness in the US that is killing birds. These are some of the stories that we talk about on this episode of Scientifics. This is Mohana Basu, and every week on the Print Scientifics, I take you through some of the top science stories of the week from across the globe. This week, scientists have found evidence that there are more lakes likely containing water under the surface of Mars than previously thought, although many are in areas that are too cold for water to remain liquid. In 2018, scientists working with data from the European Space Agency's Mars Express orbiter discovered that signals from a radar instrument reflected off the red planet's south pole, revealing a liquid subsurface lake. Several more such reflections have been announced since then. In a new study, scientists from NASA described finding dozens of similar radar reflections from around the south pole of the red planet after analyzing a broader set of Mars Express data, but many are in areas that should be too cold for the water to remain liquid. While there is still some uncertainty regarding whether or not those signals are evidence of liquid water on the red planet, they appear to be much more widespread than earlier thought. The research offers scientists a detailed map of the region that contains clues to the climate history of Mars, including the role of water in its various forms. Also this week, a near-perfectly preserved ancient human fossil sitting in a museum in China since the 1930s has been identified as a new human species named Homo longi, or the Dragon Man. This species may be more closely related to humans than the Neanderthals. In fact, Homo longi lineage may be our closest relatives and could reshape our understanding of human evolution. The fossil is one of the most complete human cranial fossils in the world. It preserved many details that are critical for understanding the evolution of the humans and the origin of our species, Homo sapiens. The massive skull could hold a brain comparable in size to modern humans, but had larger, almost square eye sockets, thick brow ridges, a wide mouth, and oversized teeth. While it shows typical ancient human features, the skull is different from all the other previously named Homo species. Scientists believe that the cranium came from a male individual approximately 50 years of age living in a forested floodplain environment as part of a small community. Given that the individual was likely very large in size as well as the location where the skull was found, researchers suggest that the species may have been adapted for harsh environments, allowing them to disperse throughout Asia. Meanwhile, a mystery disease is killing birds across the US, with many victims suffering from crusty eyes, swollen faces, and the inability to fly. Scientists are yet to find the cause of the illness. Reports of dying birds with eyes swelling and crusty discharge, as well as neurological signs, first emerged in May this year. According to the US Geological Survey, no definitive cause of death has been identified yet. Some states have created an online system where the public can report encounters with sick and dead birds. The species affected so far include blue jays, common grackles, and European starlings, but other species may have also been affected. According to the US Geological Survey, birds congregating at feeders and baths can transmit disease to one another. They have recommended that people stop feeding birds until there is more clarity on the cause of death, clean the feeders and baths with bleach solution, and avoid handling birds. While it is not known if the deaths are linked to the bird baths, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention in the US warned in April about a salmonella outbreak linked to wild songbirds across several states in the country. The outbreak killed 8 people. In other news this week, scientists have developed an innovative way to use NASA satellite data to track the movement of tiny pieces of plastic in the ocean. Microplastics form when plastic trash in the ocean breaks down and forms small flecks that can be harmful to marine organisms and ecosystems. They can be carried hundreds or thousands of miles away from the source of the ocean currents, making it difficult to track and remove them. Currently, the main source of information about the location of microplastics comes from fisherboat trawlers that use nets to catch plankton and unintentionally microplastics. The new technique relies on data from NASA's Cyclone Global Navigation Satellite System, which is a group of 8 small satellites that measure wind speeds above the Earth's oceans and provide information about the strength of the hurricanes. The team looked for places where ocean was smoother than expected given the wind speed, which they thought could indicate the presence of microplastics. They then compared those areas to observations and predictions of where microplastics gather in the ocean. The study found that microplastics are more likely to be present in smoother waters, demonstrating that satellite data can in fact be used as a tool to track ocean microplastics from space. Meanwhile, the ground temperature in at least one location in Siberia crossed 48 degrees Celsius on the year's longest day, according to data by the European Space Agency's Copernicus Sentinel satellite. The 48 degrees Celsius temperature was measured on the ground in eastern Siberia. These temperatures are land surface temperatures and not air temperatures. The air temperature was around 30 degrees Celsius, which is still unusually hot for Arctic Circle, which could speed up the region's melting permafrost. The permafrost prevents ancient caches of greenhouse gases from re-entering the Earth's atmosphere and heating it up further. That's all for this week. This is Mohana Basu, special correspondent at The Print. If you like our videos, do consider paying for a subscription to The Print. You can do so through the link in the description box below.